Welcome to Using Census Data with Excel. I'm Adam Heckman. Two-dimensional mapping makes it very quick and easy to create a map based on your data. For example, let's create a map based on the 2017 population. I can either click on Maps and choose Filled Map, or I can click on Recommended Maps and notice that Excel is smart enough to recognize that this was geographic information and that might want a filled map. Now, Excel treats maps just like any other chart. So I can do things like give this a meaningful name, 2017 population estimates. I can edit my data labels. I can format my data series. And notice that format data series has some map specific information here that I can change, like the map projection. I can make it automatic, or if I want something that is specific, like Mercator, to make it a little bit more rectangular and preserve the size, I can do that. Now, let's say that we want to plot on a map median household income for each state, along with the number of people in each state that have completed high school education. A lot of times, having a static map is fine, but sometimes you want 3D maps. 3D maps allow you to discover insights you might not traditionally see on a two-dimensional table or a two-dimensional map. And further, with 3D maps, you can plot not only geographic data, you can plot temporal data or time series data on a 3D globe to see how it changes over time. And you can create visual tours of your maps to share with other people. So let's get rid of this map. Instead, let's say that we want to do a 3D map. Now, as soon as I click on 3D maps, Excel goes out to Bing to automatically geocode my data based on its geographic properties. So you'll see these little dots on each state. Excel has acknowledged that my state field probably means a state or provenance. And I can do things that you would expect. I can zoom in, I can tilt, I can pan around, do all the basic stuff. But let's go ahead and start building out our chart. Since we want to look at population information, I'm going to make the height of the bars reflect the state populations. Now, this is almost what I want, but what I really wanted was to have each state have a separate bar for each year. So for that, I'm going to change my visualization type to a clustered column chart. Best practice with 3D maps is always to name your layers. So we'll give this a meaningful name. And you'll also notice that Excel automatically created a legend for me based on those field names. I'll move that out of the way here. So again, I can move in and out here. Let's zoom out a little bit. One of the problems with this map is I can see that there is a clustered chart or a column chart for each state, but I can't really tell which states those are. So I'll click on Map Labels, and that again will go out to Bing and bring in label information. Now, if I wanted to, I can flatten this map out and take a look at it that way. Zoom around, tilt, but I'm going to preserve the globe here and turn the flattened map off. Over on the right, you'll see that I have filters, so I can filter out my data. Maybe I only want certain states, or maybe I only want certain years. I can click on layer options. I can change the colors of the bars. I can have it preserve or get rid of zero and negative values. Also, notice that I can click on each of these objects, and I get what's called a data card. And I can customize what goes on those data cards when I click on them. I can also annotate these with text. And then in the next section, I'll show you how to do some more sophisticated analysis with your 3D maps, including adding temporal data.